This is a picture of Max and me back in 1976. I'm the one with the polka-dotted shirt and curly hair sitting on Max's lap. We met in college in 1975 and became friends, and we've kept in touch ever since then. And guess what? This is us today. Max is an actor. He has an office job with the Screen Actors Guild. And he's taking acting classes and going out on auditions. And I'm learning how to be a filmmaker. I'm asking Max to tell his story. And he has a very special story. So I'm going behind the camera now.
I got out of intensive care. When I was wounded, I was air-evac'd from where I was wounded by helicopter to a hospital ship off the coast of Vietnam. The captain of the ship took a liking to me and he wanted to give me my Purple Heart. I was in a body cast at the time and there was nowhere else to pin it. So he pinned it on my sheet. I'm not scared of dying, and I... My leg is missing 6 inches below the knee and it fits into a socket with what they call a gel liner, which kind of protects the piston action of the stump into the leg, and it's really cut down on abrasions considerably. I have a unique stump in that it's very pointed. In fact, the other amputees used to make fun of me at Walter Reed because my stump was so pointy. They used to say I stepped on a gook pencil sharpener instead of a booby trap. I felt like Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Even the amps made fun. But anyhow, I have to have a new leg probably every 2 to 3 years. They just wear out. I just had a new one made recently. I'm waiting for the regeneration pill to be developed, but I'm not holding my breath. Now troubles are many there as... When they took us out of the field, we had smoke grenades to bring helicopters in to signal our position. So I had my Christmas ornaments in a grenade canister and some tinsel that I put in my Australian boonie hat. I stood in front of a smoke grenade, appearing as the spirit of Christmas, Vietnam, 1969. I don't know whether I would have been as physically active as I am now if I hadn't been wounded. I had to develop my own physical therapy program when I was in Walter Reed. Usually when you lose a limb, they try to get you in the prosthetic device as soon as possible so the muscles don't atrophy. In my particular case, my amputation was a traumatic amputation below the knee, and it was a booby trap, and someone else had tripped it. We were on this one fire base, and we lived in these little metal huts for the month of November. When I was at Ohio State, I used to work in the commons that they serve food to the students, and the women that worked there kind of adopted me, and they sent me this package with all this food in it, with a little inflatable snowman that said, "Have a cool Yule." So for a couple of months in November and December, I would carry that with me and inflate it and use it for a pillow. I never really believed in the war. I was a draftee, but I was raised in the Midwest. Things like getting out of the draft or going to Canada just weren't in me at the time. A lot of people look at me now and say, "I would have gone to Canada. I would have never gone." Well, that's all retrospect, and we were very young, and it was in the 60s. But I never did believe in the war, and I had my peace medallion. My code name on the radio was Flower Child, and everybody took kind of a humorous view of this. In a world to carry on, to carry on. I think the main thing for me has been to develop the ability to let go and move on and go forward. You don't have to negate what happened to you in your past, but you live in the present and plan for tomorrow and do it. You can't mourn forever. There's a place for it, but you have to go on. And I think that that's basically what I've done since then.
Sitting downtown in a railway station, one toke over the line. I'm waiting for the train that goes home, sweet Mary, hoping that the train is on time. Sitting downtown in a railway station, one toke over the line. Who do you love? I hope it's me. I've been changing, as you can plainly see. I felt the joy and I learned about the pain that my mama said. If I should choose to make a part of me, surely strike me dead.